Hey, brothers and sisters, this is Brother Patrick, your most favorite, absolute favorite brother from another mother. Hope you guys are all doing all right tonight. Myself, been getting packed up, ready to move out, go back to the Philippines, praise the living God for his glory, for his grace, brothers and sisters. God is good all the time, hallelujah, and all the time. God is good, brothers and sisters. He's steadfast and unmovable, hallelujah. Hallelujah. He is great and greatly to be praised. Hallelujah, brothers and sisters. Lift up your voice. For the word of God says the Spirit of the Lord inhabits the praises of his people. Hallelujah. Brothers and sisters, you got to get under the spout where the glory comes out. You know, you got to get in to Christ. You got to get into that strong tower. For the word of the Lord says, like that song, you know, the name of the Lord is a strong tower and the righteous run into him. And they are saved. You know, the name of the Lord is a strong tower. The righteous run into him and they are saved. Hallelujah. Praise his name, brothers and sisters. It's all about him. You know, there's that song, you know, I think about it about people lots of times, you know. You know, it's all about you. The Michael W. Smith song. It's not all about us. It's all about the Lord. Hallelujah. Brothers and sisters, I've told you many times and I'll remind you again that you spell joy one way, J-O-Y, Jesus, others, and yourself last. Most people have no joy because they spell it you, others, and then Jesus last, brothers and sisters. That's why most of the Western church in particular is so dead, because so many people have made it, you know, it's the me generation, as they used to say back from the 60s. The me generation is all about me, 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 selfishness. They're afraid of offending others, but they're not afraid of offending God. Like I've mentioned many times, I have relatives, all many of you do too, claim to be Christian, but they put themselves first, number one, and number two, they're worried about offending others. Oh, we better not say nothing. Oh, we better not say nothing about gay marriage. You know, we better not say anything about this, you know, about jihadists or whatever, because we might offend somebody, offend others at the expense and the cost of offending our Lord and our God. As the word says, grieve not the Holy Spirit. Grieve not the Spirit of the living God. Hallelujah. You don't need nobody on your side but one. You don't need nobody on your side but Jesus, brothers and sisters. It doesn't matter what man thinks. That's why Jesus said, don't fear the one who can throw you body, you know, into a burning fire, but fear the one who can throw you body and soul into hell, hell fire. Brothers and sisters, there's only one judge. Brothers and sisters, I've told you since I started making videos, I preach for a one-man audience. Not to be a people pleaser or a man pleaser or an ear tickler. Like old Joel Osteen is the prime example. We, you know, it's an easy one to always throw out. Robert Schuller, who is now, you know, dead, Crystal Cathedral. I just saw, brothers and sisters, you know, I don't hardly ever watch TV. I flipped it on this morning and flipped it around looking for some kind of preaching. You know, I ran into Robert Schuller's grandson. You know, he's on there preaching. He's got a slick hairdo and all that stuff, and it looks like some kind of a puppet, you know, with that same old power of positive thinking, you know, same old people pleasing stuff, brothers and sisters. Hallelujah. Remember this, when Noah was on the ark, brothers and sisters, there's a few of you who are God pleasers. Most people are man pleasers, people pleasers. And number one, of course, people are on the throne themselves. You know, get off the throne and let God get on the throne of your heart. You know, you're on the throne of your heart. Get off. Get other people off the throne of your heart and let Christ be on the throne of your heart. Let Christ rule and reign in your mortal body, Paul said. Hallelujah. You know, there's many people, you know, they're obsessed with self-glorification. And they think that I just talked with Brother Gary and he was telling me about Joel Osteen, which I already know. I talk about it many times, brothers and sisters, that, you know, people, and even people that are friends of mine from YouTube, they'll make a statement like, well, you know, so-and-so on YouTube has 50 or 75 or 100,000 subscribers, you know, and they have more subscribers than you. They must be doing something right. No, brothers and sisters, no. It's not necessarily true and it's not necessarily false. I want to say this. Remember this. Those of you who are God-pleasers, not people-pleasers, as an example, you can ask somebody on YouTube, oh, are you pre-trib or post-trib? They won't give an answer because they don't want to offend anybody. See, because they spell Jesus with others first, but in reality, they're spelling it with a Y because they're putting the you themselves first, that they may be famous, that they may be exalted, that they may have whatever it is that they may want, fame, money, whatever people do, that is the heart of their flesh heart, that's their motivator, you know, just to get attention or finances or fame or whatever people are motivated by, whatever lust compels them to put the Y first instead of the J, Jesus first. As I said, there's many Americans who are politically correct, put others first. Remember this, those of you who have a like-minded with me, they want to spell it Jesus first, J-O-Y. When Noah got on the ark and the flood came, brothers and sisters, there was only 8 people on there, and they were his sons, his wife, and his sons' wives. There was only 8 people, brothers and sisters. So by the measure that even people that I am friends with on YouTube measure by, Noah was a failure. Jesus Christ himself, brothers and sisters, after the Bible says that he was seen by over 500 people at one time after he was resurrected. Just at one time he appeared, over 500 people at one time saw him. But in the upper room, brothers and sisters, there was only 120 people, brothers and sisters. Only 120 people in the upper room. So by that standard of the world, brothers and sisters, the Lord himself was a failure. He died alone on the cross. But what did he say? You know, and that's where we really are, brothers and sisters. We're just like the Lord. We're in that garden in the midnight, in the garden of good and evil, brothers and sisters. And that's the place, if you want to be a mature Christian and you want to put Jesus first, you got to be like the Lord himself when he was in the garden of Gethsemane after the Last Supper. And he knew that he was betrayed into the hand of the world to be crucified. He knew it. And he began to pray. And it says he prayed so hard, his sweat was as if it were drops of blood. As if it were drops of blood. And as he sweated so hard, he said, "Father, if there's any way possible, let this cup pass from me." But he said, "Nevertheless, let thy will be done, not my will be done." Now that, brothers and sisters, Jesus came, brothers and sisters. He didn't come and operate as God on earth, as he told his disciples. "Couldn't I ask my Father right now and have 12 legions of angels show up here?" Jesus came and he was baptized and operated in the power of the Holy Spirit. Jesus operated as the Son of Man. He called himself. He operated in the power of the Holy Spirit, brothers and sisters. Not in the power of the flesh and not as God, but in the power of God, the Holy Spirit, he operated in. As an anointed Son of Man, man of God, he operated in. And showed us not only the way to heaven is through him, but he set the example, the Lord set the example and standard for us of how we ought to live as Christians, the perfect standard. A lot of people look at the apostles. This is what Peter did. This is what Paul. Look at what Jesus did. He's the one that walked the earth in the perfect will of God. So when he was in that garden, brothers and sisters, many of you are in that garden. You know, we have those trials, brothers and sisters, when we're in that garden of temptation, of darkness, of somebody, you know, death of somebody in our family, divorce, so, you know, our spouse leaves us, things like that, brothers and sisters. We're in that valley of the shadow of death, like our Lord was in the Garden of Gethsemane, brothers and sisters, that night. And he knew he was going to be betrayed. But he chose. It says Jesus was tempted in every way but was without sin. He chose to do God's will that night, brothers and sisters. He chose to do his will. He chose, as he said, "Father, if there's any way, let this cup pass from me. But nevertheless, let thy will be done." Hallelujah. Brothers and sisters, are you at that place in Christ where you say, "Let thy will be done. Let thy will be done. Let that will be done in me as it is in heaven." Hallelujah. Praise God, brothers and sisters. Worship him, praise him, and honor him every day. God bless you all. God bless you all.